Yes. Folks, Dr. Paul here. We are going to go see a baby, and this baby is 9 days old.
Wow.
Had some initial jaundice feeding issues.
Hello, hello.
This is a little cutie pie that I think we're about 9 days old now. The story was born 9 days ago, C-section or regular?
Regular
vaginal delivery, and then you saw some yellowness appearing. Was that the first concern?
Yeah, they actually told us at the hospital that he was looking a little bit yellow.
Okay.
So.
We saw you here 4 days ago, and it was, or
2 days ago.
2 days ago, and it was 16.7, mm-hmm. I believe.
Yeah.
So I'll show you the bilirubin curve. In fact, let's go look. In fact, if you guys want to follow, I'll show you.
Okay.
It's kind of cool to see it and understand what we're talking about here. We're going for a little stroll down to the chart right here. You can get this at billytool.org, and this is days of life. I'm sorry, hours, right? 12 hours, 24 hours. And we're down here at several days. And you've got low risk, high risk, and these low and high intermediaries. So at this stage, if we're over about 17, we're into the high risk.
Okay.
And if you think about the time spent under this curve of being yellow, this is a measurement of bilirubin,
mm-hmm.
It's the total exposure that's the risk,
okay.
Right? So if you're super high, but it goes right back down, that's not too bad.
Okay.
If you're moderately high and you stay there, there's the danger. When we're looking at jaundice, the two ways you get jaundice to go away, that bilirubin that's being made, is one is you can expose the skin to light, and so sometimes we'll do light therapy. You haven't needed that because you were just sort of just below the danger zone.
We had him take naps by the window.
Did you? That can work, yeah. Actually. My patients from India know this. If the grandmas from India, if those babies are at all yellow, put them in the sun, right?
Yeah.
So they know this, and viewers here can see there's a hint of yellow on the face. That jaundice had gone all the way down. So just a reminder, guys, I am in the fight for my life. The medical board is after my license. They're trying to shut me down. This is a battle to save my practice, save my work, save my mission, and save my medical career. Go to drpaulsfight.com. The link's in the description below. Thank you for your support. Face. That jaundice had gone all the way down to the toes before, and now you can see the feet are basically pink. So the yellowness is, it starts here, it moves on down, and then it goes away this way, with the whites of the eyes being the last to clear up. So we still have a little bit of yellow down to the abdomen here, maybe slightly the top of the legs, but it's going away. But what I was gonna say is, besides the exposure to light, the most important thing for getting this bilirubin out is good feeding.
Mm-hmm.
Volume of breast milk, you're breastfeeding, and it's going well, I heard.
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
And you're being a phenomenal mom because I think you're nursing every couple hours.
Yeah,
that's like
two to three.
That's awesome. That's exactly what it takes, because the more you pee, that pee comes out extra
peeing.
Yellow.
He's peeing,
yep.
He's pooping.
And you pooping out yellow, right?
Yeah.
That's getting rid of the bilirubin as well. I haven't told anybody what jaundice is. Mm-hmm. Dr. Paul, you're slacking. So jaundice is simply another term for your yellow.
Mm.
And if it's on the whites of the eyes, we actually use a medical term called scleral icterus. Icterus is just another term for yellow. So we have all these terms to confuse you. But basically, you've got a yellow baby. The skin is yellower than it's supposed to be. Well, the reason for it, and then I'll get to the problem with it, the reason for that yellowness is a natural process. Babies are born very pink compared to their parents.
Mm-hmm.
And that's because babies have extra red blood cells at birth. They have extra red blood cells because they were in the womb and they were getting their oxygen from the blood that flows through the umbilical cord from mom.
Mm-hmm.
They're not breathing yet.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't extract oxygen as efficiently from blood as you do from breathing.
Mm-hmm.
So you need more red blood cells to carry the oxygen around so you have enough. At birth, breathing starts, you don't need all those red blood cells. In fact, they're a little bit of a danger for blood clots to have such a high hematocrit. And so the body is actually set up. I don't know how exactly it happens, but every baby starts losing some of their red blood cells. And in that process, when they break apart, they release this pigment called bilirubin. Mm-hmm. The heme molecule of the red blood cells attached to bilirubin, they break apart. That bilirubin is what turns you yellow. Mm-hmm. And we need to get that bilirubin out. And that's where good feeding and exposure to light will help get rid of that bilirubin. The real reason we take this seriously is, as I was showing at the beginning of the video, that curve. If you got too much time for too long, I've only seen this once. And this was a case where the baby never got follow-up. They were born in the hospital and they showed up in the ER 3 weeks later having seizures. And it's a condition called kernicterus, starts with a K, and it is permanent brain damage. The high levels of bilirubin stain the brain permanently in a way that is causing brain damage. So you don't have to worry about that.
That's good.
Yeah, we are so far away from that sort of risk. I am 100% sure you have nothing to worry about. But that's why, for the viewers, we take jaundice seriously in the newborn period. Not a concern at all in the first week. It's when you go on week after week and sort of, oh, it's normal to be yellow, and you don't pay attention to the fact that, you know, maybe the breast milk didn't come in and the jaundice is lingering and it stays very, very high for too long.
Okay.
So that's why we take it seriously, but you guys are in great shape. You guys now know. So if you have a newborn and they're very, very yellow, don't ignore it. See somebody, at least get it evaluated. They actually have some cool ways of checking it now with just a transdermal process. The actual blood test is more accurate, so that's what we're doing, but it's getting easier and easier to assess this. I'm pretty sure they'll have an app for your phone soon if they, if they don't already. I'm behind the times if they do.
We'll patent one.
Oh, patent one, yeah. So anyway, thanks for watching. I'm Dr. Paul, and thumbs up. Put some comments for this cute baby and this wonderful family that allowed you to peer in on their life and learn a little bit more about jaundice, kernicterus, the importance of good breastfeeding, adequate volume. And actually, if you don't have enough breast milk, this would be one of those situations where you would supplement with formula. Because it's important, right? We talked about the risk of the kernicterus. So that's it for now. Thanks for watching. I'm Dr. Paul.